Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum, dear students. Today is our lesson number 2 of Cambridge International ASM A Level Mathematics, level score 970. We are studying paper 1 of A Level syllabus, which is pure mathematics. Syllabus content we have started the topic quadratics. In this topic, in the previous lesson, we have studied the first subtopic, how to write a quadratic expression in completing state by using method 1. In today's lesson, we will learn how to express a quadratic in completing state form by using method 2. In this method, we write the given quadratic ax squared plus bx plus c. It is not necessary that the expression should have all the three terms. There may be ax squared plus bx as identity to the given expression. If you are asked to write this expression in this form, so you will write this expression as an identity to this. If there are different signs, so you will put the given expression by using the same signs here, like this. That is, ax squared plus bx plus c is identically equal. These three lines indicate that this expression is identically equal to this one, the given expression, required expression. And then we will expand the right hand side by using a plus b whole square formula. It will give us ax squared plus 2abx plus ap squared plus q. We have collected the terms which are 3 of x. X squared multiplied with a gave you ax squared. P squared multiplied with a gave you ap squared. And 2xp multiplied by a is 2apx. And plus q is this. Now we will compare the coefficient of both the sides, because these two sides are identically equal, so it means the coefficient of x square on left hand side and coefficient of x square on right hand side should be identical. So it means a is equal to a. The coefficient of x on this side, left hand side, is b. We will compare this with the coefficient of x on the right hand side, which is 2ap. B is equal to 2ap, from here we will find the value of p. P is equal to b over 2a. And then we will compare the constant term. Constant term on left hand side is c, there may be any number. And on the right hand side it is ap squared plus 2. Put the values of p and a, which we have already calculated, in this expression. And find the value of q. Q will be equal to c minus ap squared. Using these values of a, p, q in the required form, in this form, you will put the value of a, p and q here, will give you the required completed square form of the given expression. So these are the steps involved in writing the quadratic expression in completing square form by using method 2. Let's look at an example of this method. So we are asked to express 2xk plus 8x plus 5 in this form by using method 2. So what we will do, you will put this expression identically equal to this expression. Like this, 2xk plus 8x plus 5 is identically equal to this expression, because you are asked to express this in this form. I have already told you that there may be different letters, a, p, q. There may be a, b, c, or there may be p, q, r. You will keep the letter same, and there may be different signs here, minus p or minus q. Now, in the next step, we will expand this right hand side. 2xk plus 8x plus 5 is identically equal to axk plus 2apx plus apsk plus 2. Spelling this will get this. Now we will compare the coefficients on both the sides. Coefficient of x square in this right hand left hand side is 2, and coefficient of x square on right hand side is a. So the value of a is equal to 2. Coefficient of x on left hand side is 8, and coefficient of x on right hand side is 2ap. Compare these two and find the value of p for here. A is equal to 2ap. The value of a is 2, and p will give you p is equal to 2 here. Now, equate the constant term, which is 5 on left hand side, and ap square plus 2 on the right hand side. Put these two equal. 5 is equal to ap square plus 2. And this will give you, we will put the value of a and p to find the value of q. 5 is equal to 2 into 2 square plus 2. And from here we get p is equal to minus 3. Now we will put these values of a, p and q in this form. 2x square plus 8x plus 5, which we were asked to write in computer square form, and we have substituted the values of a, p and q to get the required form. So this is the way we can use to write a quadratic expression in completing a square form. You can use method 1 or method 2, which you like, but it's better to use method 1. Exam technique. Often you may read a question and feel that you cannot answer it, but don't give in. Spend some time looking at the problem, draw diagrams to help bring out the problem if possible, and enable you to review it from a different perspective. Don't give in. Read again and again and then try to answer the question. Now try these questions please. Express in this form. These are the questions for your practice. You can use any of the two methods that we have discussed to solve these questions. In the next lesson we will study the uses of quadratic expression, which is written in completed square form. So what are the uses of the completed square form? How we can use this form to find different things? This is my profile. You are requested to subscribe this channel. And you are also requested to click like or unlike the button. Be very clear, if you like this video, then click the like button, and if you do not like this video, so then you may click the unlike button. So there should be equal numbers of likes and dislikes as there are number of views. So please do like or dislike and also subscribe this channel so that the videos of next lessons can be given to you by a notification. The notification of the next video can be given to you. Practice. Mathematics is practice only, because practice makes knowledge perfect. Thank you for watching. Allah Hafiz.